even anything, just hungry.
Normally, I do shower before I have my breakfast, like 95% of the time, but it's currently almost 11 in the morning and I am ready for some food. So we're gonna skip the shower for now. Obviously, it's gonna happen after because I feel disgusting, but I need to get into some breakfast. It's been a minute since I last opened a package on my vlogs, so you guys know how much I love my froyo, and what's better than froyo than protein froyo. I reached out to this company on Instagram and told them that I really, really want to try their product. So I am super excited because they hooked it up. We got some mint chip froyo. The macros are 1.5 fat, 19 carb, and 10 grams of protein, 3 fiber for 81 grams. So that's a pretty decent serving. We also have vanilla bean, Dutch chocolate, pistachio. Oof, coconut. Damn. I love coconut flavored stuff. Blueberry, pomegranate. I don't know if that's gonna fall. That's probably gonna fall. Dark chocolate toffee. Oh, there it goes. Okay, that's not happening. And then we got mocha. So super stoked for all of these. And they are non-GMO, gluten and soy free, good source of fiber, low glycemic, and they use RBST and RBGH free milk. The ingredients are skim milk, whole milk, whey protein concentrate, xylitol, coffee concentrate, that's for the mocha one though, sugar, natural flavors, inulin, cocoa treated with alkali, and yeah man, that's super excited. I am so stoked to try these out, let you guys know how I like them. Proyo, thank you so much for hooking it up. I will put all the information down below as per usual, that way you guys can check them out if you're interested. I just had breakfast. It's really early in the morning, but it's never too early, or you're never too full for freaking froyo, especially because the mint chip is actually, no, it's not really thought out at all. Do I do it? I don't know. I look slightly more presentable than when I last saw you guys. Look at how thin my hair is. I miss my extensions, but it's okay because we are gonna work on making my hair strong and healthy. That way I don't have to depend on nobody, no damn extensions, to have a thick, luscious hair. But I just wanted to kind of read my caption to you guys because sometimes I write things and like literally just writing it like gets my heart fired up. So I just wanted to share it with you guys because maybe it'll make you feel the same way. When I write my Instagram captions, I always start it off with like something to do with the picture. But when I post a picture, it hasn't always been like this. It's just something that I've kind of like started doing as of like, I think a year, maybe over a year. But I really like to reflect on like how I'm feeling, things that have happened in the past week, in the past day, and like that's what always inspires my captions. And I always do acknowledge the picture though, and like kind of say something about the picture, so it's not like completely random and just like a picture with a caption. But it was just a picture of me earlier today training in my red kicks, and I said, another like workout in the books, another step closer to my goals. And then here we go. I definitely consider fitness and competitive bodybuilding to be one of my passions. It fulfills me, gets me excited, and just makes me happy in general. I love how it challenges me and it helps me grow as a person. In the past 3.5 years, I've had plenty of days where I face struggles in my journey, but facing those challenges is what makes me so passionate about this sport. In this day and age, too many people think that to find their true passion or their thing, things should happen smoothly. No bad days, no challenges. It's all supposed to be handed to them, and that's what makes it right. But that is why so many people struggle to find their passion, because it's far from that. The moment things don't go their way, it's time to move on. But guess what? You're supposed to have bad days. You're supposed to face challenges and struggles. You're supposed to work for it and work damn hard while you're at it. This is all part of the journey. Whatever journey you are on right now, the struggles and the challenges are what makes you fall in love with something. When you earn something through hard work, you will not want to let it go. That is what makes it your thing. That is what makes it your passion. I don't know why, but that just like gets me so damn fired up, because like it's so true. Like I just see so many people, especially like in my age group. Obviously, like we're still at an age where we're trying to figure everything out. We want to find our passion, we want to find our thing, but like no one is willing to actually take a risk and try something and work hard at it. They get into something and then it just doesn't really go their way. They just quit and like move on to the next thing. It's like you're never gonna find something if you don't challenge yourself, if you don't take a risk. Like, how are you gonna find out what you're capable of and what you can achieve and what you can accomplish if you're not willing to challenge yourself? So I feel like a lot of people struggle to find their passion, but the reason is that they're not willing to actually work to find their passion, if that makes sense. You know, like, nothing in life is supposed to be easy. Nothing in life is supposed to happen smoothly. I still have yet to find one person who literally has not had one bad day. So, like, people need to just learn to accept that it's part of life, accept that it's supposed to happen, learn how to just keep on with their life and not let that slow them down, and just keep going. Like, yeah, that's all for right now. I need to go grocery shopping. Yeah, let's go grocery shopping. Let's go to the mall, and by mall I mean the grocery store. Publix, to be more specific.
Arrived at Publix.
But where is it? This is why I have trust issues. Siri, where is Publix? Because I don't see it. Publix, where are you? Last time that I went to a Publix and I took my camera in there with me, I was literally being followed by the people that work at Publix. So I actually said something to them. I was like, I'm sorry, am I doing something wrong? Like, did you guys think that I stole something? Like, why are you following me? Because it was literally so obvious and just so rude. I think it's so rude when they do that, especially because I wasn't even carrying a bag or anything. Like, I had nothing where I could even put something if I did steal something. And then I was like, am I like bothering you with my camera, or like what am I doing? And that just goes to show like how annoyed I was, because like normally I would never say something like that to someone. But she's like, oh, actually, I didn't even notice that you were filming, or we're not even following you. He's just training and like just trying to like make excuses. And she just goes, you actually can't film in here though. So I like threw myself under the water for being so sassy, but I was just like annoyed. It's like, don't follow people around if you like, you have no reason to. Like, you're wondering, I'm drinking some Crystal Light in there, the strawberry kind. They have this new Crystal Light that has caffeine in it. It's only like 60 milligrams, but it's still caffeine and it still tastes amazing, and it's calorie free. Here, but the goal for this grocery trip is to buy everything
I need and nothing else. So we're gonna go by the list. What I'm about to grab was definitely not on the list, but I have been craving pizza for a long time, and you guys know how it goes. When you're craving something, you should just give your body some of it, even if it's just a little bit. And this pizza actually has really decent macros, so we're gonna do it. That definitely went really, really well. Didn't get in trouble for filming in there, so that's good. There is a reason why I brought this bag with me into the vehicle, the front seat. Front seat Retta. These are from Florida. Samia, my friend that I went and visited in Morocco, actually showed me these when we hung out here in Florida. There's 14 carb, 8 fiber, 4 protein, and 3 grams of fat for one of these cookies. And you guys, let me show you how big these are. Like, I'm only gonna have one. Yo, check this out. They're so good. My trunk is still open, god damn. If my food wasn't back there, I wouldn't be going to fix it. But since there's food involved, we're gonna fix it.
That is about it for this grocery trip. I don't really want to go into detail with everything that I bought because I feel like most of it you guys have seen on my channel before. I just basically wanted to take you grocery shopping with me because I love that public screen wise. It's dreamy in there. It's better than a mall. But that is going to be about it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you give the video a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel and you enjoy my content, then make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you have any questions for me, anything to tell me, make sure to leave it down below. Thank you so much for tuning into the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will catch you in the next one. Mwah.